When I'm doing a picture and I've got the story and I don't know where to put it, like, you know, the background, the setting for it, I go back to a place I knew as a child and I remember the room. I draw in the furniture and the room and then put the story in there. So I've got, it's like a stage set. So I've got these memories of rooms where I put the story in.
And the proportion of who's tall and who's small. And
Yeah. And my when we moved into the new house, there was, you see, my father was working in Marconi in Lisbon. That's broadcasting. He's had a lot to do with broadcasting, and he was involved, I think, with a lot of propaganda that the British, you know, put across and everything. And I think he did. I know he worked for the British because he flew to England during the war. In fact, he took the plane before the one that was shot down with Leslie Howard in it. Mm-hmm. And they say they thought Churchill was in it, but in fact, poor Leslie Howard got shot down. And my father had taken the plane before. And I remember my mother being so worried, she even made me sleep in the bed with her, which was, and they used to go to the casino a lot. And there was a woman in the casino called Miss Cook who played the piano. And you know, she taught a step dancing. And I met her the other day. Do you know, after all these years, I met her once more, and it was quite extraordinary seeing her again. She was quite important, and she's in one of my pictures called War at the Bottom. Anyway, they used to go to the casino, they used to come. They never gambled, I think they just drank and they danced. They danced a lot in those days. Then all these refugees turned up. A lot of girls turned up from places like Poland and they were very much admired by the Portuguese men because they were blonde, tall, and they would sleep with them, you mm-hmm. see, where the Portuguese wouldn't. Anyway, not officially. And then the Portuguese men were crazy about these blondes. And they would be hired to teach children. I did a picture, as a matter of fact, called, what's it called? It's got Tony dressed up as a girl.
Uh-huh.
What's that called? I can't remember.
Oh, I know. A recent picture.
Yeah, a very recent picture, which I got, because that recently I went back mm-hmm. to relive those things. I was doing The Pillow Man, which is a recent picture. I began to do a lot of research about Portugal during the war, mm-hmm. because I realized at one point that The Pillow Man, which is the play by Martin McDonagh that I loved, had a great deal to do with my father.
The Pillow Man.
Yes, mm-hmm. it did. Talking to Marco, I thought,
yeah.
It suddenly came to me that it was something to do with my father. So I went to the Imperial War Museum and did up a lot of reading on Portugal and the refugees during the war. And the amount of people that passed through Portugal, Saint-Exupéry, Stephen Zweig, Thomas Mann, Max Ernst, immense amount of people. Some stayed for a little while. Saint-Exupéry stayed for a little while, mm-hmm. gambled a great deal, I believe. And the others it was just a way through to America, really. Mm. And they would catch the boats to go to America, the ships, mm. you had to have a special permission to be able to leave the country. And a friend once needed permission, had to go to Lisbon to get permission. He just arrived. He was a refugee from France. He'd been a resistant fighter. And he'd gone to Lisbon to get a permit. And as he was coming towards the quay to catch the boat, there'd been a strike going on with the stevedores protesting against the low wages and everything they got. And he saw, as he was getting near, he saw all these men gathered together and shouting and singing. And he also saw the Guardia Republicana, which is the guard police, on horseback, coming and shooting everybody. They must have shot 300 people.
Just flattening it to get through. Yeah.
And he went on and got in the boat and left as quickly as possible. Not a word of it in the newspapers, of course, because there was a great deal of censorship. It was all censorship. We talked about was football. Mm-hmm. Talked about football, but nothing else actually, really. And they say they talked about Fado, which is our national song, but they did, I don't remember them talking about Fado. And Fatima, yeah. You know, the apparition, yes. But I don't remember. I remember them talking about football, and there wasn't allowed anything. It was heavily censored, no political information. So the word of, by word of mouth, people got to hear things, mm-hmm. You know. And my father knew a lot of things because he'd meet his friends for lunch in the cafe, etc., and they would know what was going on, etc. And this was terrible, a terrible feeling of unease and unrest and so on, but all covered up. It was all going on, but all covered up. Then you'd have the smart ladies in Israel, they would play canasta, sit round tables, play canasta, have cocktails, you know, and all this was going on at the same time, this misery and this unbelievable poverty. Yeah.